Welcome to the Grace Community Christian Church, the grace that rocks, the place where God is exalted, Jesus is Lord, and the Holy Spirit is at work.
Hello, this is Pastor Chris and
Lady L.
Hey, listen, we're excited because we're preparing for you with what we call not just a reopening, but it is a relaunch. And I thank God for what has transpired over the last 90 days. You've done extremely well with the pandemic that we've been faced with, and the pandemonium and the endemic that we've been dealing with. But listen, we must also prepare for the regathering. You know, it is the will of God that the church gather. And we see that in,
Hebrews 10 and 25.
Yeah, and what does it say?
Not forsake the assembly, which is the manner of some.
Yeah, in other words, it's important that we gather, because it's through our gathering that we're able to encourage, inspire each other with our testimony and also with our presence. And so listen, we wanted to take a few moments to share with you what you can expect in the upcoming days as we welcome you to back to the church house, but also to understand we're going to welcome you back to what we like to call affectionately now as the City of Faith.
The City of Faith.
And somebody asked me, well, why are you calling it the City of Faith? Are we changing the church name? No, we're not changing the church's name. But everything that we have done this far, and over these last few years, over these last 18 years, and even during the pandemic, has been by faith.
By faith.
And so we truly believe that when you drive up, you're going to be driving up on what we call Faith Boulevard, baby. Hello, come on, talk to me now. And so listen, we're going to talk about these four phases. Now, there's four areas,
yes.
And we want you to know that we've considered you, and also there are three phases. Can I just start with the first phase?
Yes.
You know, when we relaunch, beginning the first Sunday in August now, phase one includes all of our leaders. When I say leaders, I'm talking about our ministers, our elders, our deacons and deaconess. And so we want to bring them back first, and we want them to be comfortable with understanding the protocol and the processes and how we're going to be operating. Because we understand that as they are comfortable, then when you come back in, then they'll be able to also make you comfortable. So we'll have them in for a couple of weeks before we begin to open up. And then phase two then will include the idea of inviting our members to register.
Yes.
Our partners and members, you'll be able to go online and register. We'll probably take about the first 100, we estimate, and that we can accommodate you and make sure that we do all the social distancing things and things of that nature. So that will be phase two. And then phase three then will include the opportunity for everyone to return. And then we'll gradually lead into it.
Right.
And also with phase two, it'll include some of our team members as well. You know, those who lead different areas of our ministry will be included. And so we thank God that we're kind of slowly easing our way back in. And I must admit, now, those of you who have health challenges, we understand your health challenges.
Right.
We want you to stay where you are.
Stay at home.
Stay safe. Mm-hmm. And stay connected to us.
Yes.
And then also, we're going to kind of gradually, not in phase one, but probably not even in phase two, not include our youth ministry. But mm-hmm. you'll be able to come bring your children, but you'll have to sit together as a family. So we have a very comprehensive plan for how we relaunch our ministry. Now, I've kind of talked about the phases, but now I want you to kind of elaborate, because Elle has put together what I call the dream team to help us relaunch. And there are four areas for which we relaunch.
Right.
And one of those areas, the first one is called the environmental phase, environmental area.
Right.
And can you just kind of elaborate on what that looks like?
Right. Environmental services is going to be dealing with disinfecting. Mm-hmm. Disinfecting the whole church, inside as well as outside, just to make sure that every area is safe and clean
mm-hmm.
for you.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. Now, not only that, but now we've got some video footage that I'm pretty sure they're showing you now that even shows that we've even had the air treated.
Yes.
Not only have we had the air treated, but we've had the sanctuary repainted. And you know, we've done those things to make sure that you're feeling comfortable and you're knowing that it is safe, clean, and most of all, it is still a sacred house, a gathering. So we have the environmental team, and then the other team we have right after that would be what we call our volunteer team.
Correct.
Can you talk about our volunteer team?
So yeah, our volunteer relations deals with medical services mm-hmm. and healthcare.
Yes.
So that we know we have our thermometers, the infrared, that we will be checking temperatures.
So when people come in,
correct,
they'll be able to just shoot the gun at them?
Yeah.
We'll be able to shoot the gun at you. Check your temperature.
Checking your temperature. Yes. Yes, just make sure if there's any health questions or anything, we're going to have staff here available to assist in that area.
Yeah, we also want you to know that we'll have signage to go along with that.
Correct.
And so, you know, we'll have signage as you come out. But listen, what we need you to do is we need you to follow the instructions.
Correct.
And because, you know, we're concerned about you, but we're also concerned about ourselves.
That's right.
And we're concerned about ourselves because, you know, I have to visit and take care of my mother. Mm-hmm. And I want to make sure that I don't contract anything that I would drag into her home.
That's
and
correct.
Likewise for your parents down in New Orleans.
Yes, we're going to be visiting them real soon. So I want to make sure that I stay healthy as well.
Yeah. And then, so we have the, we've just named, what's the first one we have? We have the
environmental service.
We have the
volunteer relations.
And then we have guest relations.
Guest relations.
Yeah, what talk about guest relations?
Yes, that's including our wild team where we're going to be.
The wild team.
Yes, welcoming and waving.
Oh,
I'm
going to
do a Wakanda move.
Oh, what are we going to do? Walk on. Hey,
we will not be touching each other.
We won't be touching
at all.
We
maintain our social distancing. We have signage. We have floor signage that we have purchased that we're going to have placed throughout the whole, building as well as in the sanctuary to make sure that everyone maintains their social distancing. Also in the restrooms, all over the building, all on the outside as well. So to make sure that we are in compliance with the CDC. That we're doing our part. And guess what? Because we care, we want to make sure that you are taken care of properly.
Not only that, but then the last team that we have, the last area that which we've really put a lot of work into is what we call our in-service team.
That's correct.
Can you talk about what the in-service team compiles of?
Right. It really is dealing with the security, everything that's going to go on during the service.
Yeah.
Overseeing how we do communion, how we do offering, if we're going to do, we're not even sure. I don't think we're going to do prayer call or anything like that at this time.
Yeah.
But we do have, we will have our signs with our 6 feet apart.
Yeah.
So we'll have those signage throughout the sanctuary as well.
Yeah.
Just everything that's dealing with the service,
yeah.
we have a team that's going to be helping with that.
And then we also want you to know that, you know, we're going to require and ask that you bring masks. Oh my goodness. But if you don't have a mask, guess what? We got masks for you. And then
for all
of our volunteers, all of those who are working with our WOW team and our environmental team and our what's the other teams that we have?
We have guest relations.
Guest relations and in-service team. Guess what? We got masks and we got gloves for you as well. Mm-hmm. And so listen, we're proud. I'm so proud of you.
Yeah, we got hand sanitizer.
We got hand sanitizer?
Yeah, you know we have the sanitizing stations.
We got a sanitizing station?
Yes, we do. We have masks. We have our disinfectant wipes.
Yeah.
We have we have been stockpiling it up to make sure that we take care of you.
So we can wear our mask and not have to worry about somebody getting ready to rob us and stick us up.
That's right.
Oh, glory to God. Hey, listen, I'm excited for what God is doing through the relaunch as we welcome you back here to what we call the City of Faith.
The
City of Faith.
Yes.
Hey, listen, because we walk by faith and not by sight. And listen, we're grateful to God. And you know, your grace is still rocking. Praise the Lord. Listen now, as you have heard all of the wonderful things we're doing in planning the relaunch and welcome you back to the city called Faith.
The City of Faith. Yes.
Listen, what we want you to do now, we want you to make this go viral. We want you to let everybody know. Listen, I need you to share on your page. I need you to post it on your Insta story, Instagram, IGTV, wherever you got it. Put it on YouTube. Put it under your arm. Carry it with you. Hey, remember, it's the Grace Community Christian Church. It's the City of Faith where God is being exalted.
Jesus is Lord.
And the Holy Spirit is
at work.
Lift up your hands in your worship wherever you are. Hallelujah. And give God a good praise. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hey. Come on, throw your hands up wherever you are. Receive our love, and as we shout. receive our praises. Help me say, as we love on you. Let's go. Come on and worship him right here. Hallelujah.
Beautiful, fashionable, elegant, vivacious, caring, wonderful, hardworking. Happy birthday, Lady Lenone.
I know Incredibles 2 just came.
I'm gonna fight bad guy.
Yes, go ahead.
But I also know Aunt Lenone is an incredible
Now we're gonna have Bishop Ash inspiration worship.
One time for the birthday cheer. Two times for the birthday cheer. Three times for the birthday cheer. Go ahead and wish your birthday cheer.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Lenone! Yay!
My sister!
We're so excited for you. You're a good friend to us. We love you dearly, and we are so excited that we have an opportunity to say happy birthday.
Happy birthday. And listen, we're looking forward to seeing you real, real soon. Make it great. Chris, I know you know how to treat a lady. Do it right for her. And again, we love you.
That's right. Love you. Mwah.
Bye-bye.
Happy birthday.
Hey, sis.
Hey.
It's your birthday, shorty.
It's your birthday, shorty. It's your birthday, shorty.
Now, you know, we couldn't celebrate any old kind of way. Baby, we put our shades on for a cool person like you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, sis.
Lady Chappelle, my sister and my friend, I am so honored to call you my friend. And God is so good for connecting us and bringing us across each other's paths. I was super excited when Dr. Chappelle sent me a message and asked me to record a video for your birthday. I was like, absolutely, I would love to do that. I love you. I think you're incredible. I think you're classy. I think you're jazzy and sassy, all the stuff that I love. And again, I am so happy that we're friends. Have an amazing birthday.
Hi, Lenone, it's Mashondia. Happy, happy, happy birthday. I pray today will be amazing and your wildest dreams will be fulfilled. I'm grateful to have a sister in the faith like you. You're happy, you're loving, you're always laughing, and you're just a genuine down-to-earth person, and I love you for that. So from my family to you, again, we wish you a very happy birthday and enjoy your day. It's all about you. See you soon.
Hello, this is Apostle, and I have some very good news. Please mark the date Monday night, June the 29th at 7 p.m. Central Time, that I'm coming to your area with a one-night virtual Faith for Crisis Situation Faith Tour with a dynamic one-night faith-building teaching session to prepare you to overcome life's most challenging times. Now, in the time we live, we are facing a myriad of crisis situation, the COVID-19, the racial unrest, the domestic pressures, and the economic turmoil. We need to know how to effectively stand in faith for God's best. Now, years ago, when I was facing severe crisis in my own life, God gave me a revelation on applying faith under pressure that has made the difference in all of my faith fights and victories. Now, this teaching on faith for crisis situation on Monday night, get this, the 29th, June the 29th at 7 p.m. Central Time will help you in every area of your life, help you in your health and help you in your finances, help you with your family matters, help you in your career and ministry. Now remember, this is our virtual faith tour and it'll be live on Facebook as well as YouTube, and it's absolutely free. That's right. This is my personal invitation to you to join us, to be in the virtual audience that night, along with other friends and members and partners and pastors from around the nation. You know, Pastor Bridget and I, along with other pastors, we were so looking forward to being with you in this time of fellowship in person this year. But with technology, we can still get this powerful message of faith and ministry to you safely and without risk. So go to newlight.org for more information and free registration. That's right, absolutely free. And you can use your smartphone by texting FT2020 to 71441. Now, if you register, you become eligible for the free flat screen giveaways that night. That's right. We're going to give away more than one. Share this night with others. It's going to be big. Mark the date and be in the place for the Faith for Crisis Situation Faith Tour, Monday night, June the 29th, 7 p.m. Central Time. You will experience a refreshing time in faith that is like none other. Go to newlight.org for more information.
Hello, this is Pastor Chris, and of course, Lady L is missing today, but the Lord impressed upon my spirit a great idea. I began to share it with L, and she thought it would be a phenomenal idea that we would take an opportunity to reach out to you. You know, it's been 120 days or so since we have had an opportunity together, and I realized that the value of our being galvanized and connected is so vitally important to the relationship of our spiritual growth. And so now, I begin to read Proverbs 27 and verse 23, where it says, that we should understand and know the condition of the flock. So listen, we have devised a plan. We like to call it up close and in person, where we reach out to you, to all of our families in the month of July in alphabetical order. In other words, there'll be groups of families that will connect with us through Zoom. You know, A, B, C, of course, you know, B1 group, D, E, F, until we get all the way through through our families and make sure that we understand your journey, see where you are, hear our heart, hear how we're planning to relaunch our ministry, understand our journey, understand your journey, and I truly believe that it's going to be a most memorable time. You know, we're going to be up close and in person, and so I want you to now, when your group is being summoned, to make plans to join in with us in the month of July, and guess what? We're going to make it simple, we're going to make it safe, and of course, it's going to be in a sacred time. Hey, listen, we're going to only take about 30 to 40 minutes of your time, and listen, I'm looking forward to seeing you up close and in person.
Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter.
I'm a young black man, doing all that I can to stand. Oh, but when I look around and I see what's being done to my kind, every day I'm being hunted and prey. My people don't want no trouble.
They're marching with one message, social justice.
Distance and police have been firing pepper spray to try and disperse this crowd. Hundreds of protesters have gathered here, and now police are trying to push.
Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter.
that there is a clear distinction between what you can do and what you should do.
Mr. Brooks's family say he'd been celebrating his daughter's 8th birthday shortly before he was killed.
Nobody's trying to find a vaccine for why officers pulled the trigger so quick on African Americans.
I just wanna live. God protect me. I just wanna live. God protect me. I just wanna live.
Black Lives Matter.
Well, hey, you know I'm excited about the praise and worship. God is in the building. Aha! Listen, come on, can we just begin to give God some praise? Come on here, lift your hands. Come on here, magnify. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. An incredible God deserves an incredible praise. I feel the presence of the Lord in this place. And listen, the same God that's here is the same God that's in your home. The same God that's in your workplace. The same God that's in your travel space. Oh, goodness, come on, let's praise the Lord. Yes, come on and lift those hands. Oh, come on here. Now, I know you're in the luxury of your home, but would you just stand? Would you stand and just begin to exalt his name? Would you stand and begin to elevate his name? Oh my God, his name is higher than all of the earth. His name is to be glorified. His name is to be extolled. His name, oh glory to God. There is nothing that is above the name of Jesus. And so we glory to your name. God, we exalt you. Hey, listen now. Listen, here's another opportunity as we want to celebrate all of those that are working. I know you say, well, he did that last week. But listen, when people go out of their way to make sure that they provide the quality of ministry that allows us to come into your home, they deserve, watch this, they deserve some salute. So would you put your hands together and thank God for those, our praise and worship team, our band, our lighting team, our video team, and everyone that's working, our audio sound, whatever they're doing. Listen, shout out to all of you. We thank God for you. And listen, when we have the relaunch, when you come back, you're going to get a chance to experience them as well. Hey, listen, also, what I want you to do now is don't forget that today is Lady L's birthday. Listen, it's coming up June the 30th, and we're going to celebrate it today. And so, but I'll talk about that in just a minute. But you know what I want you to understand? It's harvest time. You hear me talk about the idea of harvest time. It is harvest time. And the word of God, I'll go back to it, Genesis 8. And 22, it says that as long as the earth remains, watch this, as long as there's winter, hot and cold, as long as there's darkness and light, here it is now, there will always be seed time and harvest. So now in order to have a harvest, it requires a seed. Now, you know, when I think about that, I was reading just the other day, I was reading 1 Samuel chapter 1, Hannah, whose womb was barren. And she begins to cry out to the Lord, says, Lord, how is it that my womb is barren? She says, Lord, but if you were bless me with a child, I will take, watch this, I will take this child and I will offer him to you, watch this, as a sacrifice, as an act of gratitude, as an act of thanksgiving. And so she does so. Now listen, watch this now. The word of God declares because she made a vow, because, watch this, she made a commitment to God, watch this, with the fruit of her womb, okay, when you get to 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 5, the Bible says, now how is it that at one time my womb was barren, but now here it is, I have 7 children who have come as a result, watch this, of my making a commitment. She says, now listen, praise be to God. She began to magnify and thank the Lord. Listen, I am just like Hannah to the fact that I remember when my life was barren. You can remember when your life was barren, but when you look around and you see all that God has done for you, then you understand now that guess what? Giving will make room for God and heaven to get working in your life. I am a product of the tithe and offering. My daddy would always tell me, son, you can't outgive God. How many of y'all remember that old Baptist song we used to sing that no matter how hard you try, just keep on giving, because it's really true that you can not outgive God, no matter how hard you try. And so guess what now? Listen, our church is a product of the environment of giving. Oh, yeah. Well, our church has a culture that has been taught for us to give. And so listen now, we understand that when Hannah makes a commitment, she understands the idea of seed time and harvest. She plants a seed, she gets an incredible harvest. She gets supernatural return. I see it in 1 Kings chapter 17. And this widow woman in verse 10, the prophet comes to her and she said, a little water, and listen, I don't have much because we're in a drought, I don't have any food. He says, give it to me first. And guess what she does now? She goes from dying to living. And the Bible says that after she obeyed the voice of the prophet, she put a seed in the ground and she has a harvest to come. I see it in John chapter 6 and verse 7. The disciples and Jesus were looking around at the multitude, says, now listen, how will we feed all of these people? They said, now what will a few days of wages do to meet the multitude? They said, we don't have enough. But then they recognize there is a boy who has 2 fish and 5 barley loaves. He puts it in the hands of the disciples. The disciples give it to Jesus. Jesus looks up to heaven and he begins to give God thanks. And the Bible declares that not only, watch this, did he feed the multitude, but there were some left over. A seed was planted, and because the seed was planted, it created a harvest. Now watch this, okay? We looked at Genesis 8 and 22, seed time, there's a harvest. We looked at 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 11, there was a seed that was planted, and guess what? She had 7. Looks like multiplicity is at work. We see it in 1 Kings chapter 17, a woman who says, I don't have much, but I have a little bit. But guess what? She makes a commitment to release it. And the Bible declares that every day she had some left over. Looks like seed time and harvest. We see it in John 6 and chapter 7 through 9. We see that they said, what will this do among so many? But they planted a seed. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. And guess what? They had more than enough. I see the results of this. Watch this, can be summed up. Oh, glory to God. In Job chapter 7 and verse 8, it says, so small shall your beginnings be, but so great shall your end be. Listen now. It starts out little. It starts out like maybe 10% is not a whole lot. But I'm here to tell you, God takes this 10% and he begins to multiply. And he ensures and guarantees that you have a harvest. And then those say, well, that's tangible. Let's make it spiritual. Jesus, glory to God, as a seed, as a first fruit offering, goes in the ground. But when he comes out, multitudes of say millions have been saved. Why? Because a seed went in the ground. A seed, watch this, seed time produced a harvest of souls. And I'm here to tell somebody, your seed is going to create the harvest that you need to get life working the way God's desire for it to work in your life. And listen, what I'm asking you to do now is to join me, join others, join our ministry as we make a difference in not only in your life, but in the lives of those, watch this, in our community. Those in our, not only in our community, but those in our state, those that are in our country, and those that are around the world. Listen, because our ministry has a local imprint, but it has a global impact. So you know what? It's offering time. It's seed time. But more importantly, it's harvest time. Hey, listen, we have a plethora of ways for you to give. Of course, you can give online. Not only online, but you can also use our text to give at 678-203-9989. And then, of course, you can use the Cash App, #, My Grace Rocks. And then for those of you who would like to come today, listen, we're asking that you come and join us today for the parade celebration of Lady L's birthday. Listen, what I want you to do now, you can bring your tithes and offerings to the church. That's right. You can bring them. And guess what now? You can come around. Listen, you wear your mask and gloves if you want to come in and use the giving kiosk. It's available for you. Hey, listen, I truly believe that this is a momentum game-changing opportunity for you and for our ministry. And I'm believing God, listen, for some incredible things to happen in our ministry. By August 31st, it's going to require your participation. Hey, make a commitment to your tithe. Make a commitment to your offering. And then, truly enough, make a commitment to Lady L's birthday today. Hey, listen, God bless you and keep you is my prayer. Come on, put your hands together and let's begin to praise the Lord. Come on here now as the praise and music ministry come and give us songs of inspiration that's going to elevate, create the atmosphere. And I'll be back with today's message in just a moment. God bless. Bye-bye.
Somebody lift up your hands wherever you are. Come on and worship the King. We serve the only true and living God. Hallelujah. And we call him the I Am. Help me say,
I have everything.
everything I need. Yeah, I have everything I need. I have
everything I need.
The great I am.
The great I am.
Oh, do you believe that? Yeah.
The great I am.
Listen, help me say,
You are my strength when I am.
Is it your strength?
Weak.
You are my strength.
You are my strength when I am weak.
Lift up your voice and say, You are
my strength when
I am weak.
The great I am.
Oh, yes, it does. He's Jehovah Jireh, my provider.
The great I am.
Yeah.
Oh,
come on, check it out. The great I am.
The great I am.
Come and say
that I am.
Is everything that I need.
That I need.
The great. Whatever I need you to be, you're a present help in a time of trouble. You are the I am. When all my strength is gone, your strength is made perfect. When all my strength is gone, your strength is made perfect. You are my light and my guide, the strength of my life. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? 'Cause I serve the I am. I serve the I am. I serve the I am. You are the I am.
You are the I am.
You're the I am.
You're the I am. You are.
You're the only God.
You're the I am.
God before you.
You're the I am.
I hope you are enjoying today's service. Oh, it is incredible. God is in this building, but I know that God is right there with you because he's an omnipresent God. He's everywhere at the same time. And I'm in celebratory mode because I understand that I'm here today only because of the grace of God. I'm here today because God has been better to me than I could have been to myself. And for that reason, I'm here to tell you that God has smiled on me. He is the cause, yeah, of all my joy. Yeah, fills me with his love. Oh yeah, y'all hear me singing that? Every little thing that I need, he sends it down from up above. Come and say it now, God has, hallelujah, smiled on me. Yeah, he has set me free. Oh, God has smiled on me. Yeah, he's been good to me. Can I sing one more verse? Yeah. He is the cause, hey, of all my joy. Fills me with his love. Yes, he does. Every little thing that I need. Yeah, he sends it down from up above. Come on, everybody, sing God. Has, yeah, smiled on me. Hallelujah. He has set me free. Oh, God has smiled on me. Been good. He's been good. Woke me up this morning. Started me on my way. He's put food on my table. Is there anybody know he's able? He's been real good. Yeah. He's been good to me. Hallelujah. I felt it in my spirit. Yes, I did. I felt that in my spirit. Hey, do you believe? Come on, look at somebody in your household. Look at somebody in your workplace. Look at somebody around you. You're sitting at the traffic and just smile at them. Tell them, God's been good to me. Hey, praise the Lord. Listen, come on. Let's magnify the Lord. Oh, come on here. Let's come on. With the fruit of my lips, I'll give him a sacrifice of praise. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continuously be in my mouth. Hey, listen, this is another day the Lord had made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad. What I need you to do, those of you that are watching by way of Facebook, you know the drill now. Listen, what I want you to do is I want you to share the page, that little arrow, the little word share right there in the right-hand corner of your page. If you just share that to your page, that doesn't cost you anything. But I'm telling you, it's going to make a difference for someone that you really love, someone that you really care for. Would you just share the page? And then for those of you who are watching on YouTube, then guess what? Right there's a red arrow, I think it is, or either black arrow, but the word subscribe is in red. If you just click that and subscribe, listen, we need your support. We need to know that you are engaged. And guess what? We want to keep in touch with you so that we can understand that all of our partners, all of our members, and all of our guests are connected, watch this, to the root of this ministry, so that you can experience God's best for your life. And then for those of you that are watching on our webpage, what we want you to do is to get your phone, and we want you to text somebody, tweet somebody, and let them know that they can watch us at mygracerocks.org, and they can be connected as well. Hey, listen, I'm grateful to God. You know, shortly, now, immediately after the service, now I want you to come on by, because we're going to have a rolling parade for Lady L's birthday. I'm believing God that you're going to come. We're praying and trusting. Now, listen, wear your mask. You know, you don't have to get out of the car. Just roll through the parking lot and honk your horn, and if you want to drop off a love gift for her, that'd be great. But listen, it's not mandatory for you to bring anything. We just want to see you guys. We've missed you. And listen, we look forward. It's been over 90 days, and I'm so used to having you in the house with me. So listen, come on by, and I won't be long. Listen, because listen, I truly believe that we ought to honor her, and we want you to be a part. Hey, listen, are y'all ready for the word? Let me hear you say word up. Word up. Come on, listen. Let me hear you say word up. Come on, type it on the screen. Word up, word up. And ha-ha, glory to God. Can I get somebody in the house to say word up? Word up. Yeah. Listen, come on, shout it out loud. Shout it to the rooftop. It's time for the word of God. And that's why you're tuned in. Hey, listen, there is a phenomenal word, a dynamic word. Watch this, a rhema word that God wants you to receive today. It is found beginning with James chapter 1. James chapter 1 and verse 2. This is what it says. It says, count it all joy when you face trials of many kind. because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Now watch this. I want to read it from the Message translation. Can I read it? From the Message translation, it says, consider it a sure gift, friends, when tests and challenges come, watch this, at you from all sides. You know that under pressure, your faith is forced into the open and shows its true colors. So don't try to get out of anything prematurely. Let it do its work so you become mature and well-developed, not deficient in any way. So today I want to talk about the idea of crunch time faith. I believe they got it on the screen. Somebody holler back at me, crunch time faith. Now watch this. This idea of crunch time, when we look around, and we see, you know where I'm going, when you see the pandemic, when you see this coronavirus, and you see the impact that it's having on our society, every nation, every country, watch this, every township has been affected by this pandemic. And then when we see the pandemonium around the world of dealing with race relations and racism that has put this country on the brink of another civil war between the fractionalizing our country between black and white because of the color of our skin. And when we see the endemic, the continued oppression of a race of people, and we see the genocide that is being brought upon our black males, it lets me know that we're, watch this, in a political fight, a political battle, oh yeah, that's coming up in the month of November. It lets me know that this is crunch time. Glory to God. And in order for us to deal with everything that's going around us, we got to have what I call a crunch time faith. Come on, somebody just say a crunch time faith. Now, when I listen, now the essence of this message is to help you, watch this, is to help train you. It, watch this, because you can only prosper through this time of crisis to the degree for you which you have been taught the word of God. Let me say that again. You can only thrive and prosper in the midst. You can only come out of this situation, watch this, on top. Based upon, watch this, to the degree and level that you have been taught faith, and you know how to apply it in the midst of, watch this, of pressurized situations. So listen, the Lord began to talk to me about this idea to tell the people how to have a crunch time faith. I believe that there are several different kinds of faith. When we look through the Bible, he says that in Mark chapter 9, as the people were standing around, and he says to them, O ye of little faith. And then he goes on to say at other times, O ye of no faith. You have no faith, you have little faith. But then I also believe that he gives us what I call the crucible of faith. What is the crucible of faith? That idea of crucible means that it has the ability to melt an object. And God gives us a faith that I believe that will melt and bring the world to its knees. That is a crucible faith. But then I also believe that God gives us what I like to call today a crunch time faith. Glory to God. So listen now, when I think about this idea of crunch time faith and understanding that I must coach you properly to how to deal with pressurized situations. If the truth be known, all of us are feeling pressure. But not only that, but then I also understand that when I'm feeling pressure, I can go to Philippians chapter 3, verse 14 through 16. He says, I'm putting those things behind me, watch this, and I'm pressing toward the mark. So I understand that when I'm under pressure, glory to God, when I'm in a crunch situation, when I'm in, okay, let me use another word, when I'm in a pinch, when my back against the wall, then I understand that I got to tap into a level of perseverance that allow me to press my way through until, watch this, I obtain the outcome that brings glory to God. Okay, so watch this. I understand now. Paul, the writer James helps us to understand that as he writes this text, he helps us to understand now that there comes a time when you're going to have to count it all joy. Now listen, not that I'm ecstatic because of the pressure that I'm under. Not because I'm extremely excited. Listen, you know, to understand that I've got a deadline that it doesn't look like that I can meet. Not that I'm just gonna, you know, just smile and just everybody, you know, I'm so glad that I can't pay all my bills. Come on here now. But when he talks about count it all joy, listen, you can count it all joy because you understand the outcome from the beginning. Glory to God. What do you mean by that? In Isaiah 46 and 10, he says, for I am the Lord God who declares the end from the beginning. So now I can count it. Watch this. I can count it. That, guess what? I refuse to allow a few months of a pandemic to outweigh, oh my God, my history with God. Let me say that again. I can count it all joy because I understand, according to Isaiah 46 and 10, I understand the outcome from the beginning. The God who declares the end, glory to God, from the beginning. So now I understand that while I'm under pressure, watch this, I've got to press, I've got to persevere. That word persevere means that I've got to push my way through the difficulty. I got to push my way through the pain. I got to push my way. I feel like preaching. I got to push my way through the problem. I got to push my way through the pandemic. I got to push my way through this pandemonium. I got to push my way, glory to God, watch this, through this endemic until I can see God getting glory. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now listen now, so I understand. But then, watch this, when he says you face trials of many kind, listen, so I've got to persevere, trials of many kind. In other words, now you also have to deal with persecution. I see that in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 12. All kinds of affliction, persecution. We see that he says, rejoice, Matthew 5 and 12, and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. So now watch this. I can count it all joy because I understand I'm not the first one to have to deal with a pandemic. Oh my God. This is not the first pandemic in the world. Come on, somebody. This is not the first time the economy has been challenged. This is not the first time you didn't know how God was going to come through, but didn't he come through? Glory to God. This is not the first time, watch this, you felt pressure from all sides, but did not the Lord deliver you? And if he delivered you then, he'll deliver you now. So guess what? I can count on all joy. Because I remember, watch this, the God who declares the end from the beginning. And I remember when I didn't know how, I didn't know who, but I knew God would, and guess what? He did. Glory to God. So watch this. They're dealing with persecution, trials of many kinds. Dealing with, watch this, I've had property to be confiscated. Listen, I'm talking to somebody right now. Hebrews 10 and 34. He says, you suffered along with those in prison and joyfully accepted the confiscation of property because you knew that yourselves had a better lasting possession. So guess what? Listen, I need to understand something. You don't have to be embarrassed because you've lost some things along the way. Oh, glory to God. Listen, I'm talking to somebody. Watch this. You don't have to. I'm talking to somebody right now who's unmarried. You don't have to be embarrassed. Listen, don't allow this moment to embarrass you because of the outcome of your marriage. It didn't work out. Listen, for somebody who's dating, you're unmarried. Don't allow, watch this, the loss of the boyfriend or the girlfriend that everybody thought you was going to marry. You got jilted at the altar. Don't allow, watch this, don't allow the world to put pressure on you, but understand you have lost some things on the way, but you got something better on the way. Glory to God. Listen, those of you who you had your house repossessed, you had a car repossessed, lost your job, you had some things that brought shame to you, but don't be ashamed. The only way you can be ashamed is if you accept shame, and I refuse to be shamed. So I'm here to help somebody now that this is a crunch time. So guess what? Trials of many kind. We've had property confiscated, we've had persecution we've had to deal with, but then he also says now that we have had some pain. James 1 and 12, he says, blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. So I understand now that I can count it all joy in the midst of the pandemic. I can count it all joy in the midst of crunch time, because God gives me a faith that will not shrink though it is being pressed by every earthly woe. Oh my boy, if my daddy was here, he could listen. Even in his dying days, even in his last days, even when he didn't know his name, well, when I would begin to say, daddy, can you say that for me, he says, Lord, give me a faith, oh my God, that will not shrink though I'm being pressed by every earthly woe. Oh my God. And so what I need you to understand, this crunch time faith means that guess what? I will not, oh my God, my faith will not shrink. Oh my God, I will not back away from what I heard God say. I will not, watch this. I will not, oh glory to God, I will not cut back. I will not cut out on God, because God has given me a faith that will not shrink. Oh my God, if I shrink now, then I will forfeit what God has promised me. So I got to have a faith, watch this, that will bring me through in the midst of the crunch. Glory to God. I'm believing God. By August 31st, here it is again. I'm believing God by August 31st. I know this building is empty, but I have a faith that will not shrink. I will not reduce my God. I will not reduce God, watch this, with a temporary decision. Watch this. About a permanent blessing that he wants me to have. I will not make a temporary decision, watch this, or I will not make a permanent decision, let me say it that way, about a temporary problem. Glory to God. Let me say that again. I will not reduce, God, I will not back down on my statement that I made in March about August 31st, that guess what, we'll have everything we need, watch this, to get the ground going again, to complete what God started. For he who has begun a good work in me will see it through to the day of completion. Why? Because I've got a crunch time, and now we're in the crunch. I got 60 days remaining. Watch this, to see manifestation of what I'm believing God for. I got 60 days, and I don't know how God's going to do it, but I know I heard God say it, and if he said, then guess what? He's obligated, watch this, to fulfill with his hands what he has spoken with his mouth. So I got a crunch time faith. Let me read that to you in 2 Chronicles chapter 6. I hadn't planned on sharing that. 2 Chronicles chapter 6. And verse 4. Now, yeah, that's what it is. 2 Chronicles chapter 6 and verse 4. Let me read that for you for a minute, because you can only flourish and you can only have this crunch time faith based upon to the degree for which you have been coached. So I've got to coach you to understand this. Then he said, praise be the Lord, the God of Israel. Watch this. Who with his hands has fulfilled what he promised with his mouth to my father David. For he says, since the day I brought my people out of Egypt, I have not chosen a city in any tribe of Israel to have a temple built so that my name might be there, nor have I chosen anyone to rule over my people Israel. But now I have chosen Jerusalem. But now, in the midst of these times, in the midst of this pandemic, God says it is time. It is, oh, glory to God. Oh, listen. God says it is time. Why does he say that it is time? He says it is time. He says it is time because he says he is eternal. He says, okay, somebody said, now what does that mean? He says it is time because he's eternal. Watch this. He has given us a platform called time. And in these times, God said it's time. Watch this for what I have said to you to manifest itself. Watch this, because nobody will be able to get credit. They say, well, we weren't even there, but God still did. Oh, glory. Can I get a witness there? Listen, God says it is time. Watch this. You've been waiting. He's obligated to perform with his hands what he spoke with your mouth. So he said, it is time. Watch this. Oh, my God. Nicole Hope, for you to be healed. It is time. Glory to God. Oh, my God. For Robert Holman to get the kidney. It is time. Come on, I'm talking to somebody right now. It is time for you to get up to launch that business and to get your business up and flourishing. It is time for you to, oh my God, to get that degree that you've been thinking about. It is time for you to activate that dream that you had all your life. It is. Come on, somebody say, it's time. It's time. And God is obligated. Watch this. Even in the crunch, he's obligated to perform with his hands what he has spoken with his mouth. This idea of crunch time. Listen. Let's define what crunch time is. Come on, Pastor Kimbo. Let's look at it. Let's define what crunch time. Watch this. What is crunch time? Listen. Crunch time now is it is faith to pull us through. This word crunch time. It is a faith to pull us through. It's a period of intense pressure. Crunch time meaning that I'm dealing with a critical situation. And because, watch this, because I understand now that I've got to have faith for God to pull me through. I know that it's a period of intense pressure. I understand that it's a critical in situation. Crunch time faith means that, guess what? It requires an immediate response. Watch this. An immediate response. It requires my attention so that I can experience an outcome that is greater than my current situation. Oh, glory to God. Let me say that again. When I understand that we are under intense pressure, oh, glory to God. When I understand now that this is a critical season, then it requires that I have an immediate response. Watch this. That I have an intensified attention to my present situation. Listen, believing that my outcome will be greater than what I'm experiencing under pressure. Glory to God. In other words, now watch this. In other words, let me say it this way. In crunch time faith, meaning that God wants to do something supernatural in your life. And listen, let me say this. It doesn't have to be spectacular for God to do something supernatural. Listen, let me say that again. It does not have to be, watch this. It does not have to be spectacular for God to do something supernatural. Now listen. I need need somebody to catch this right here. Watch this. Listen. I need to talk to somebody over here on my left side. I need to talk to you right now. Listen, God told me to tell you that this is no time to panic. Listen, but he wants you to persevere. He wants you to push your way through. Glory to God. Watch this. He wants you to push your way through. The woman who carries the baby. Watch this. When she gets to the moment, watch this. Oh, glory to God. Of delivery, she has to push. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Yeah. The doctor tells her to push. This is your push moment. Glory to God. I saw the NFL players the other day saying, guess what? We've come too far. Listen, we can't turn around. You've come too far to turn around now. Push your way. Glory to God. Push your way through. Push your way through your pain. Glory to God. And listen, when the pain becomes so difficult, you'll always tell people, guess what? If I can ever deliver this one, they ain't got to worry about me again. But when you see the joy, oh, glory to God, when you see the outcome of what you pushed your way through, you say, guess what? I believe I'll try it again. Glory to God. Why? Because you see the outcome of what you had to push your way through. I'm talking to somebody now. Can I talk to somebody over here, Chemo? Can I talk to somebody to my right? Can I talk to somebody in the camera 6? Watch this. The pain of your business, you're on the brink of throwing in the towel. The pain of your marriage, you're on the brink of throwing in the towel. The pain of dealing with your child, you're on the brink. Watch this. This is crunch time right now. There's no moment like today. There's no time like this time. And God told me to tell you that keep pushing. Glory to God. You're going to enjoy the outcome. Watch this. If you can endure this pain, despise and the shame, understand that guess what? God's got a great reward for you. Now listen, I'm going to have to do this in two parts. Listen, I won't be able to finish this crunch time faith today. But listen, because guess what now? I understand this is no time to panic. I understand that I've got to have continued efforts despite, watch this, the difficulties. Listen, I got to have a strong will not to be denied. I'm talking to somebody right now. Listen, I don't care. Watch this. Listen, the criteria for us completing this Project Nehemiah is not based on how many people we got. Glory to God. Listen, you don't have, let me say this again. You don't have to have a lot of money to do all that God has told you to do. If God, watch this, gives you a vision, then he's obligated to give provision. Glory to God. So watch this. Yeah, crunch. Got leads, but I'm believing God's going to do it. Watch this. I got a resolve now. And watch it. When it's crunch time, you got to have a resolve. In other words, it's got to be settled in your spirit to persevere. Watch this. You've got to have fortitude. Watch this. You've got to have, watch this, the discipline. In other words, this word discipline means that you got to have forced obedience. You got to trust God even when you can't see God. You got to trust God even when you don't know where God is. God will show you more along the way than he does from the beginning. Praise the Lord. So watch this now. I understand that I've got to have this crunch time faith. Watch this. A few years ago, I was coaching AAU basketball. I can never forget. And one of the girls that we were playing against was pushed, I think, by my daughter, Brittany. She was pushed. She cleared her out. Glory to God. She took on the enemy like her daddy taught her. Yes, she did. Brittany, you remember this? Yeah. She cleared her out. Sierra, you remember this. Kiva, y'all remember. Y'all were at the game. She pushed her under the sideline chairs. Glory to God. Yes, she did. The girl had been running her mouth. She had been talking smack. And so Brittany got tired of the smack talking. And so guess what? Listen now. This is crunch time. The game is on the line. So she took her and pushed her under. So the girl gets off the floor, the same one that was running her mouth, and she begins to cry. And the coach says to her, "Why are you crying? This is basketball." Glory to God. Get yourself up. If you're going to play, get back in the game and stop crying. That's what I want to say to you. That Watch this now. It's crunch time. And it requires a crunch time faith. Why are you crying, glory to God, about what's not right? Why are you crying because how bad it is? Glory to God. Why are you crying because you feel like it's empty? You have nothing. Why are you crying because you feel like you're alone? Watch this. This is life. And God says, this is crunch time. And he says, count it all joy. Glory to God. Get yourself back up. Get in the game. Why? Because the game is on the line. Your family is on the line. Your future is on the line. Glory to God. Your faith is on the line. This is the moment where you live out everything you've been telling people that you know about God. Yeah, it's crunch time faith. Listen, why are you crying? You do know that's why he told Moses there at the Red Sea. He said, Moses, why are you crying?
Glory to God. He says, this game, this is no time to practice. Now it's time for you to perform. Oh my God. It's not time for you to perform what you've been training for. Glory to God. Yeah, you ask the Lord to enlarge your territory. Watch this. This is crunch time faith. Glory to God. Now watch this. Watch this. Because, listen, I need you to understand. So now how do we know it's crunch time? Times are stressing our thoughts. Our patience is running out. Come on, talk to me now. It's seemingly growing darker. It's seemingly getting worse before it gets better. Watch this. But now listen, we must be able to rely on the voice of God. Okay, let me read 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1. Listen, because this becomes a case study. I told you I won't have time to finish. How much time do I have left, Lauren? How much time do I have about? Can I get 5 or 10 minutes? Can I get 5? I got 10 minutes. I got 10 minutes. Okay. Listen. Times are stressing our thoughts. Okay, watch this. Patience is running out. Seemingly growing darker. Being able to rely on the voice of God is what's most important. 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1. Elijah replied, "Hear the word of the Lord." That's what I want to tell you today in the crunch time. Watch this. "Under the bloodening of a chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears, wounds but the horror of the shade. And yet the minutes of the year shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with the punishment my scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. I am the master of my faith." He says, "Hear ye the word of the Lord." So this is what he says now. This is what he says now. Elijah replied, "Hear the word of the Lord." There's a great famine. Watch this. Cannibalism. Watch this. And you go back a few verses in 2 Kings chapter 6. They begin to eat people. That lets me know that times were bad. There were times were bad. Watch this. But now watch this. This is what he says now. The Lord says, "About this time." Woo! Yeah, it's crunch time. "About this time tomorrow," oh glory to God, "a sea of the finest flour will sell for a shekel, and 2 seas of barley for a shekel at the gate of Samaria." What he's really saying, watch this, the worst is over. Glory to God. Oh my God. Listen, what I need you to understand, the worst is over. Listen, the economy will come back around. Glory to God. Schools will reopen. My God, it will not rain all the time. Glory to God. I need you to understand, you had some things confiscated from you, but you'll get another house. I'm talking to somebody right there. Listen, your husband left you. Watch this. Your boyfriend left you. Oh, glory to God. Come on here. You'll get another girlfriend. Watch this. You lost your business. You'll get another business. You lost your job. You'll get another job. What I'm trying to tell you, that you got to have a crunch time faith to believe that by this time tomorrow. Is there anybody looking at me? Now watch this. The moment, I know I've said this 1,000 times. The moment you receive, watch this, the prophetic voice of the prophet is the moment you can expect manifestation. Glory to God. By this time, can somebody text that on the screen? Can somebody write this on the screen? By this time tomorrow, oh my God, I'll have myself back together. By this time tomorrow, I'll be back on top. By this time, come on here somebody. By this time tomorrow, I will be healed. By this time tomorrow, I won't be limping anymore. By this time, is there anybody who can say by this time? By this time tomorrow, I'll graduate. By this time, oh my God, my family will be healed. By this time, is there anybody else who can say by this time tomorrow? Why? Because I got a crunch time faith to believe that in the midst of a famine, I can say and declare, based on the man of God, by this time tomorrow. In the midst of pandemonium, I can say, by this time tomorrow. I can say it in the midst of sorrows, by this time tomorrow. Why? Because I count it all joy when I face trials of many kind. Knowing allows me to say, by this time tomorrow. I think I'll wrap it up right there. By this time tomorrow, knowing. What is it that I know? All things, glory to God, work for the good of them who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. Oh my God, it's working. Glory to God. Listen, you can't take a shortcut. God told me to tell you the elevator is closed and you're going to have to take the stairs by this time tomorrow. Listen, knowing, it is my knowing that God says I'll never leave you. Nah, will I forsake you? My knowing. Somebody shout knowing. I know that my Redeemer liveth. I know because he lives. All right, glory to God. I can face my tomorrow because he lives. All my fears are gone because I know who holds my future. And now life is worth living because he lives. I can count it all joy. The Bible declares Jesus, while on the cross, glory to God, endured the cross, Watch this. He was able to endure the cross for the joy that was set before him. Listen, this is what I need you to understand. As I close now, as I wrap this up, this is what I need you to understand. The Bible declares that Jesus was able to endure the pain. He was able to persevere. He was able to overcome the problem because there was a joy that was set before him. Watch this. He understood the outcome. He knew that, guess what? He would go in the grave, but he knew also that he would get up again. Why? Because he had a crunch time faith. The balance of the world, the balance of the sinful man was on the line, and Jesus had a crunch time faith, and so he got up. The Bible is filled with those who had a crunch time faith. Glory to God. Hannah, when her womb was barren, had a crunch time faith, and she began to worship God. She made a sacrifice, and the Bible declares, the Lord have mercy, that she said, we only have enough to eat. We're going to eat it and die. But by the word, by she believed the voice of the prophet. And because she believed the voice of the prophet, the Bible declares that every day, watch this, she had enough to eat. And what she thought was going to kill her was what God used to give her life. Oh, glory to God. When I look at the children of Israel, they were trapped at a Red Sea. There's a crunch time faith that was needed. And the Lord said to Moses, Moses, what's that in your hand? He stretched forth the rod. And the Bible declares that God made a way out of no way. It was a crunch time faith decision that brought him through. When I look through the word of God, I see Gideon, oh my God, with 300 men facing 135,000 Midianites. But he had a crunch time faith to believe that God could deliver by few, or God could deliver by many. So he gave a tithe. Yeah, he gave her, glory to God. He gave a tithe, 300 out of 32,000. Watch this. And the Bible declares that when they heard them with one sound, glory to God, they struck the lanterns, glory to God, and all of the Midianites were destroyed. The Bible declares that under the fell clutch of circumstance, you got a crunch time faith. Oh my God, that God will bring you through. Glory to God, the children of Israel, they saw their Canaan land. They saw their blessing. They saw the best of the best. And they marched around. And glory to God, because they had a crunch time faith, they stepped and they stepped and they stepped. And the Bible declares in Deuteronomy 11 and 24 that every place the sole of your feet shall step, it shall be yours. I dare you to get out in the car today. I dare you to go to that subdivision. You've been looking. You've been dreaming about it. And walk around the model home. I dare you to go to that car dealership and walk around. I dare you to go to that place of the school that you want to go in and march around and watch God give you a crunch time faith. I dare you to go to that financial institution and watch what God will do. Glory to God. Yeah, the Bible declares that when the crunch time faith was needed, yeah, the disciple says, we only have a little bit. We only have two fish and five loaves. But under pressure, under crisis, under attack, under siege of in their minds, watch this, they took the two fish, gave it to Jesus, he blessed it and fed a multitude, and they had carry out to go. I'm talking to somebody, you're under pressure, your business is not doing well, but in Luke chapter 5, Paul Peter said, listen, I've been out all night long, and I ain't caught nothing, but God at your word, glory to God. And the Bible declares that he went out and caught so much fish that he had to call help to get somebody else to come through. And can I give my own testimony? Watch this. I had a crunch time faith. Oh, 18 years ago when we launched this ministry, didn't know what God was going to do. Days when I didn't know how bills were going to get paid. Times when I didn't know how payroll was going to be met. But I'm here to tell you, 18 years later, we're still standing. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, glory. And God only knows what he's going to do in the next 18 years. But I'm leaning and I'm depending on him. Why? Because I got a crunch time faith. Listen now. Watch this. A crunch time faith. Listen, I'm not out of message, but I am out of time. And what I need you to understand now, that in the crunch, it requires that you have a definitive attitude. And it requires that you take decisive action. Definitive attitude. And it requires that you have a decisive action. Now listen. I want to take this moment now, because I didn't get a chance. I didn't get a chance to get all to you. I got so much. If y'all will stay with me next week, I'll break down what I mean by that decisive, that definitive attitude and decisive action. I'll talk about that to help you understand. Now listen, can I get this camera right here? Because I need to talk to somebody right now. Whose life is under siege now. Whose life is under pressure.
who, watch this, I need to talk to this person, right? I need to talk to you. But first thing I need you to understand is that I want to pray for you. Yeah. You got a report from the doctor, and it's weighing on you. Yeah, you got a phone call. You got an email. Watch this. Yeah, listen, I want to pray for your parents. I want to pray for your mother. Pray for your father. I want to pray for that child. I want to pray for your spouse. I'm talking, what I need you to do now, what I want you to do is I need you to send your, make that request known. You can put it on the screen there. You can type it in, whether you're on YouTube, Facebook, wherever you are. Listen, and guess what? They're gonna call out your name to me. Yeah, you can do that. Now, listen, I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. And then, or you can send it to marketing@mygracerocks.org. Marketing. They're gonna put that on the screen. At my grace, because the Lord told me to tell you that while you're on the siege, and while you're under pressure, that I'm to pray for you. I am to pray for you. Watch this, so that, guess what, you can know that somebody is in partnership with you to bring you through. Now listen, that is, watch this, what it requires for you to do that. Now it takes a definitive attitude and take opportunity, what I call a decisive action, to allow us to pray for you. We want to pray for you. Then we have a prayer team that prays every morning at 6 a.m. You can join us on that prayer line, 605-475-4000. 605-475-4000. And you can type in the access code 362-802. Now, we've been on this prayer line. We've been on this prayer line now. This coming August 5th will be 7 years that we've been praying. 7 years. Oh, glory to God. And we're seeing results. We want you to join us. We're going to put your name as part of, going to call your name out on that line. On that prayer line as well. And listen, you're going to have people all over the world who will be praying for you. People all over the world. So listen, what I want to do is I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for your family. Listen, somebody over here on camera six, I believe it is. So there's somebody on my right side over here. Watch this. There is a decision that's being made about you. Glory to God. There's a legal matter that you're dealing with, and God wants you to know that he's going to give you favor in the outcome. Glory to God. Listen, watch this. If he has to extend time to give you time to get proper representation, you're going to get a favorable outcome. You're going to get a judgment that's going to be in favor. Glory to God. And watch this. What was intended, watch this, to go against you, God's going to flip it and put it in your favor. Glory to God. Listen, so I'm praying for you. Somebody right here now, you've got a financial challenge. You don't know. Watch this. I'm praying to our church. I'm praying to our church, praying for our church, praying for those of you that are watching, other pastors, other ministries. While during this pandemic, watch this. I'm believing God, by August 31st, we'll have what we need. Glory to God. Listen, that God will put us in a position where we owe no man, that God will put us in a position that every piece of rubbish, every piece of property, oh my God, will be restored back to prominence, back to first class status. Listen, I'm believing God. And so guess what? As I'm believing God for the finances for our ministry, I'm believing God for your own personal finances. Glory to God. So that you can meet every obligation that you have. Glory to God. That no need will go unmet. Oh my God. That the chain of poverty will be broken. That the chain of lack will be destroyed. That, oh my God, the chain of not enough that has gone through your family, that the chain of mismanagement will be dispelled out of your life. God will bless you to the degree that you have enough to spend, share, save, and sow. I'm truly believing that. Listen, so I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you, and I'm praying for you as well. So now listen, I'm praying for your family. I'm praying for your family, that God's going to raise your family up. Your family, your household will be saved. And you'll be able to say, as Joshua, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I'm praying for you. So now listen. What I want to do is I want to pray for you. Let's pray. Spirit of living God, I thank you for this moment. I thank you for this decision that are being made, God. Watch it, that requires a definitive attitude, that has with it a decisive action. I thank you now, God, that you are transforming life right in our very midst, God. Right in the midst of where we are today, God. I thank you now, God, for that habitual lifestyle that the person is being delivered from. Oh, God, I pray, God, for that decision that's got to be made. Watch this. That's got to be made in that judicial process. I pray, God, for that financial challenge that is being dealt with. I pray for that sickness now, God. I pray for that negative report that has come through. Oh, in the name of Jesus, God, we dispel cancer. Oh God, we thank you now that person right here is being made whole. We thank you now that family member, that mother, that father, God, watch this, is being restored, God. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, that the children, God, that have gone wayward are being restored, God. We thank you that the family that has been in an uproar, that's been in turmoil, oh God, is being strengthened now, God. We pray now for the mind that has been disturbed. oh God, with thoughts of suicide, with thoughts of emotional unrest. We thank you now, God, in the name of Jesus, God. And we decree power over every challenge, God. Authority over every challenge. And to let the anointing of God touch and drop this very, as my voice is being heard around the world. God, speak now, God. Move now, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Loose, God. Oh, God, we cast Satan back to the very pits of hell. Oh, God, and we cast down every angel that he has dispatched against us, God. And now, God, we loose our spiritual angels. Oh, come here, Michael. Come here, Gabriel. All of the angels, oh, God, that have been assigned to us are being loose, God. Go to that house. Go to that hospital. Go to that financial institution. Go to that school. Go to that place of employment. Go to that place, God. Oh, my God. To that subdivision. Go, God, to that car dealership. Go where you need to go, God. And move, God, like only you can move. We thank you, God, that it is so. We thank you, God, that it is done. In the precious, mighty, matchless name of Jesus. God, you're raising up somebody who will use their power, their ability and influence to help us. We give you glory. We give you honor. In Jesus' name. Let the redeemed shout, amen. Amen. And amen. Come on and put your hands together. Oh God, chains have been broken. Yokes have been destroyed. In the name of Jesus, we give God praise. We give God glory. Now for those of you that are watching, you're not connected to this ministry. Listen, this is a special call for you. The Lord says that if you give us 6 months or 180 days, that's what I heard the Lord say. I didn't hear this from anybody. I didn't pick this up. I heard God say this. Listen. And so guess what? You've got to believe that it's over. You got to believe it's over. I read that in 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1. It's over. It is over. Watch this. The uncertainty that you've been dealing with, God says it's over. And now what you need somebody is to coach you up in the level of faith that you need to experience the power of God, to experience the abundant life that God wants you to have. What I need you to do is, like so many others, is to give me 6 months or 180 days. 6 months or 180 days. And I'm telling you that I can give you the scriptures and the strategies, that I can give you the principles and the precepts you need to get your life working. Well, you have experienced what I call the quattro blessings, where all the areas of your life are moving simultaneously. And listen, I'm here to tell you that God has assigned me to you. All I need you to do now is to have a definitive attitude and now take a decisive action. Listen, you say, well, we don't meet in the same. What we have discovered is it's not about the building. It's not about the building, but it's about the relationship. And I want to have a relationship with you that's going to transform your life. Oh, my God, I can't even tell you. Thousands have taken me up on this guarantee. And their lives have never been the same as a result. I got the tools. I got the call on my life. I'm assigned to be your pastor. And then, you know, then Jeremiah 3:15 says he'll give you pastors after your own heart. Watch this. Who will give you understanding and give you knowledge and understanding. That's my assignment. And so listen, what I need you to do now is to hear the voice of the prophet as I'm speaking. Take a definitive attitude and also add to that a decisive action. And you're going to experience the grace guarantee. Listen, there's a number that's on the screen. I've already prayed for you. I've already been praying for you. I've been praying for you in my quiet time. I've been praying for you in my time as I sit with my mother. I've been praying for you as I travel, believing that you are the person that God said he would send. He said he would use angels and have angels to point you in this direction. You've been waiting on somebody. The angel is talking to you now. God says he would use the Holy Spirit to guide people to this ministry. And I know that the Holy Spirit, listen, all I need you to do now is to obey God. Obey God. Somebody type that on the screen. Obey God. Talking to that person that's watching. Obey God. Obey God. Hey, now, we're going to applaud. We're going to thank God for you. As we're applauding, the number's on the bottom of the screen. I want you to text that number, 678-582-2456. 678-582-2456. And I need you to type the word connect. Type that word connect right there. And guess what? We're going to get you connected with the grace guarantee to the church like you are, to the city of faith where God is being exalted. Jesus Lord and the Holy Spirit is that word. Hey, we're excited about you. We're excited about you. We're great, grateful that you've made a connection with us today. Oh, glory to God. Hey, listen, today's service has been awesome. I'm back here with you. I'm back with all of you now. Listen, we are excited that today's service has been exciting. Listen, I'm so grateful for your participation. Now, listen, what I need you to do now, I need you to start making your ways to your automobiles. Listen, we're going to have a love train for Lady L from 11:30 to 12:30. We're going to celebrate her 56th birthday. I never knew 56 looked so good till I saw 56 on her. Glory to God. And so, listen, I want you to come, drive by. If whatever gifts you may have, we want you to come. You can also through gift or online. But listen, more importantly, we just want to see y'all. And our staff going to be here to greet you as well. Would you come on by? Would you come on by? And listen, let's show her some love, the love that she really deserves as the leading lady of our ministry. Glory to God. And so I'm grateful to God for your presence. I'm grateful to God for your participation. But I'm also grateful to God for the power of God that's at work in your life. And now to that same sweet Jesus who is manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels and received in glory, be both majesty and power, henceforth and forever. Let the religion shout, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you. Bye-bye.